love in the kitchen. Today I'm going to be preparing a Maharashtrian special recipe, and that's the urad dal curry or the black gram dal curry that is very healthy and high in protein. So yes, let's start making this lovely Maharashtrian recipe, and let me take you to Maharashtra today, and let's see what they prepare at their houses and what's their favorite meal to eat with roti, paratha or rice. Let's start preparing this recipe. So to make the urad dal curry recipe that is Maharashtrian style, these are the ingredients required. I've taken 1/2 cup of black urad dal, I've taken 2 cups of water, I've taken 10 to 12 curry leaves. These are going to add a very nice taste and flavor. I've taken around 8 cloves of garlic. These are whole, not chopped. I've taken 1 small size of ginger that I've roughly chopped. I've taken 5 spicy green chilies that I've just roughly chopped. Some salt to taste. I've taken some coriander leaves that are sitting in cold water so that they stay fresh. I've taken 2 teaspoons of oil. You can use any oil, mustard oil is fine as well. I've taken 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds or jeera. I'm going to be using a pinch of hing or asafoetida, 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, and 3 tablespoons of dry shredded coconut, which is going to add a very nice taste. So for this 1/2 cup urad dal, we will be using in 2 cups of water. So let's start making this lovely recipe. So I've taken a wet napkin. Into that I'm going to be adding in the 1/2 cup of black urad dal or split black gram. Now this napkin is wet. We are not going to wash the dal, but just clean it in this napkin. Just spread it like this. And take the corners and just rub it against. Close it like this and rub it like this. Just to get rid of all the dirt and all the powder that is used to preserve this dal. Just rub it like this for around 3 to 4 minutes. So just take the dal, just rub it like this with the corners to clean it. As we are going to roast this urad dal, we are just going to dry roast it, so it's important to clean it like this. So I've taken the dal out in a bowl, and now I'm going to roast it in a pressure cooker. So I've taken a pressure cooker, and now I'm going to switch it on medium flame. I'm going to allow it to become hot. As it's becoming hot, I'm going to be adding in this urad dal in the cooker. So it is hot, adding in the dal, the 1/2 cup dal. Now this dal is later on going to swell up, so I'm going to keep the flame on low to medium. And on low to medium flame, I'm going to dry roast this dal. Now you have to dry roast this dal for around 4 to 5 minutes. I'm going to dry roast this for another 4 minutes, as 1 minute is over. So there is a specific aroma of the roasted dal, and at this step I'm going to switch off the flame. At this stage I'm going to add in 2 cups of water. Be careful. As the dal was hot and roasted, you may just feel some sound. Now I'm going to switch it on medium flame. I'm going to give it a light stir. I'm going to close the lid of the pressure cooker. I'm going to boil this on medium flame for 4 whistles. So just remember, 4 whistles on medium flame. Do not keep the flame on high or on low, just medium flame, that's it. And take 4 whistles, then I'll show you the next process. So as the dal is boiling, I'm going to prepare the vatan. That is basically, I'm going to prepare a green spicy paste in which we are going to later on cook the dal. So I'm taking a grinder. Into that I'm adding in some coriander. This is a big bunch of coriander leaves. Next in, I'm going to be adding in 8 cloves of garlic. Next, in a small pinch of ginger, roughly chopped. So ginger, garlic. Next in, I'm adding in the green chilies. So I'm using this spicy green chilies because this is a spicy recipe. But if you do not eat a lot of spicy food, just use around 2 to 3 green chilies. After adding in the ginger, garlic, green chilies and coriander, next in I'm going to be adding in 3 tablespoons of dry shredded coconut. Now I'm going to grind this into a nice fine paste. Try your best not to use a lot of water as we want a thick fine paste. So use water only if required, or basically do not use any water. But in my case, I'm just going to grind and check if I require water. If you need to add water, just add only 1 or 2 tablespoons of water. Do not add a lot of water. So I'm going to grind this into a thick fine paste. So I've grinded this, and let me show you how this looks like. So you can see it's nice and thick. Just try to use minimal amount of water. This is how it looks like. So this vata is now ready. I'm going to keep this aside and show you the next process. So 4 whistles are done, and I've just switched off the flame. Now I'm just going to wait 5 to 7 minutes, or until the cooker pressure completely cools down nicely. So just wait around 5 to 7 minutes, and then I'll show you how the boiled dal. So I've opened the pressure cooker, and this dal is nice and boiled. You can see just minimal amount of water is left in the dal. Next in, I'm going to be adding in 1/2 cup of water, and I'm going to give this a good mix. Just mix it nicely. After mixing this, I'm taking this and I'm just going to kind of churn it, just slowly by slowly, just churn it. The dal is still hot, so it's going to be very easy to churn it. Churn it and mash it nicely. So you have to make sure that you continuously mash the dal. If you have a feeling that this dal is raw, then you can just take in 2 to 3 whistles. Usually on medium flame, 4 whistles are enough if you have roasted the dal nicely. So I'm just continuously going to mash this dal. Next in, I'm taking up another non-stick kadhai. I'm going to switch it on and let it heat nicely. Now the oil is hot, I'm going to keep this on low flame and adding in cumin seeds. Next in, I'm adding in some mustard seeds. So let this pop out nicely. The mustard seeds and the jeera are just going to pop up nicely. Next in, I'm adding in a pinch of hing or asafoetida, keeping the flame on low, adding in the curry leaves, which are nice and washed. Next in, adding in the curry leaves. I'm just going to give it a light mix. It's smelling so nice and lovely right here. So you can see this tadka is nice and ready. Next in, I'm adding in this paste that I had prepared. Just add it inside, all of it. And I'm going to fry this paste in the oil with this tadka. So continuously, I'm going to stir in. It's smelling so nice. I mean, the ginger, garlic, and look at the lovely green color. Try to use fresh ingredients for this recipe, and it's going to give you a nice and perfect result. So I'm just going to fry this for around 3 minutes. Next in, I'm just adding in little bit of turmeric powder and giving it a good mix. Make sure not to add in a lot of turmeric powder while stirring it continuously and nice. So this is done. I'm going to keep the flame on low now. And I'm going to add this dal that we had beaten up. Just add the dal, all of it, into this. So I've added in all the dal and I'm going to keep the flame on medium and I'm just going to give this all a nice mix. You can see the color is nice and maintained. I've added the cooked dal in the tadka and now I'm just going to add in some water to adjust the consistency. Adding in 1/2 cup of water. You can add water according to your preference of how much liquidy you want. If you're serving this with rice or if you're serving this with roti, just some salt to taste. Just mix this nicely well. So after adding in the salt, I'm just going to close the lid and allow this to simmer for 5 to 6 minutes on medium flame. So just close the lid and just 5 to 6 minutes on medium. So it has been around 5 to 6 minutes. I'm going to keep the flame on low and slowly I'm going to open the lid as the lid is very, very hot. Just open the lid slowly. You can see how nice this looks and give it a nice mix. Wow, absolutely stunning. Just see this. Maharashtrian style spicy urad dal curry is completely ready. I'm going to switch off the flame so you can see. You can just prepare this recipe very, very easily within no time. No need to soak the dal. So this recipe is completely ready. And now we are going to serve this recipe. So I'm going to serve this. So this nice spicy urad dal curry that is lovely and beautiful natural green color is completely ready. You can serve this with steamed rice, roti, paratha, naan or any other thing that you would want to serve this with. And trust me, you're going to love this recipe. As we have used lentils, it's also going to be very, very good for health, especially for protein. And yes, do try this recipe and let me know how this turns out for you. And yes, pure desi Maharashtrian style urad dal ghute with vatan is completely ready. Thank you so much for watching and yes, goodbye, and I'll see you in my next video with another lovely and interesting unique recipe. God bless you.